We are going to play Subnautica, which is an early access game, available on Steam, which means that improvements are going to be made kind of on a rolling basis, hopefully. Sort of like beta testing, but a little more organic. Probably with more stages of user feedback, player feedback. So we're playing this on January 5th, 2016. This is actually not my first playthrough. I had a very frustrating couple hours trying to figure out really basic things. So I finally caved and I looked up like a walkthrough and figured out really easy stuff like you can access your PDA by hitting tab, which I didn't know. I was picking up all these mushrooms, and then I just kept dying. But I think I have a slightly better idea of how we're gonna do it. So let's go ahead and play. Get wrecked. I don't know that I need to do that. So let's start a new game. These are the levels of difficulty. I don't know why they're ordered like this. This is basically just a like a sandbox mode. You don't need anything to sustain yourself. You can basically just be a mermaid, invincible, because there's a lot of building and collecting of materials. This one, hardcore mode, it's the same as survival, except you get that one life. So I don't want to do that one. Freedom is seems a little too easy for me. Probably good to start with if you have no idea what you're doing, but we're gonna play survival. And I think the story is that this spaceship crashes into the ocean. And the ocean actually becomes sort of this like alien landscape. If you've ever looked at photography or footage of deep sea, like very deep ocean flora and fauna, it's actually kind of terrifying almost. I mean, so many unfamiliar things that thrive in super hostile environments, like anaerobic bacteria, weird seaworms, things like that. So something I noticed with this game earlier is that it's set at the highest graphic settings, which even on oof. Me. All right, so in your lower left corner, you have your stats, how much oxygen you have, which will matter when you go out into the ocean environment, your health, there are a lot of environmental hazards out there, your hunger, and fresh water, which becomes important. Although it depletes a lot more slowly than some other things. So this is going to be your main kind of hub for survival. You're gonna basically gather and then come back and fabricate. So this is basically the entire hull empty. And I didn't know this was here, but so on the right you have storage. On the left you have inventory, which are things that you're carrying on you. So I don't know that we need any of those right now, but we can also, these are all slots where we can dump items that we don't quite need. So if you need something, you just press tab. Let's head out into the ocean real quick. So you can exit from down below or up top, and you're going to be picking up salvage metal. I don't think we really need the mushrooms yet, but... Ooh, come here. Alright, we got one thing to sustain us. The first time I played, I had a really, really hard time gathering food, and that was like what I spent basically an hour doing. So just real quick, so first of all, if you bring back a fish, it will register it as now a known component, a known creature, and you'll be able to cook it or cure it. You can't cure it unless you have salt, but we're going to eat this. So that brings us back up. So what we want to make basically is, first we're going to want to make a tank. So we need titanium, and we have glass in our storage pod. And then we're going to want to make fins. So let's go look at how to make silicone. And some of these recipes for products kind of bother me, because I work a lot with metals and casting rubbers and whatnot. And I mean, creating like pure quartz glass in these conditions would be impossible, but that's not really interesting to you or to me, I guess. So we're looking for crystals, which are a lot easier to find at night. Break the limestone. Where is the limestone? And I'm about to drown, so... Oh, here we go.
Emergency.
You get a warning. You have like a tiny bit of leeway where if you're like just close enough to the surface. Let's see what we have. Copper ore. We really don't need that right now. Salvage metal is good. That can very quickly be turned into titanium, which you can also find as ore. And the deeper you go, you really don't want to go very deep right now. You're going to run into some... What was that? Good. So we have some titanium. I don't remember how much titanium we needed. Oh, there I am. But here's some quartz. I think we need 4 pieces of quartz to make a... silicone rubber elements. There are a lot of really beautiful things down here that maybe you shouldn't touch. I actually haven't encountered this, but there are a couple of things out there.
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Ooh, I'm like no clipping through. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Let me in. Certain creatures that have like air bladders, air sacs that let's go. We need a put this in here, I think. So I can't remember exactly what we needed for the tank. No, I think we have enough. So that'll
The Aurora, zero life signs detected. Lethal radiation levels detected. The main drive core has malfunctioned.
We need two more.
Dark matter containment field has dropped to 36% temperature.
We need two more pieces of quartz. So that increased our ability to stay down by quite a lot. And I'll pick you up just because it takes up a lot more space in your inventory though. I believe it takes up 4 slots. So if you're out hunting for, come here you. Oh, I don't need you yet. Oh. Nope. Sometimes you get eaten. I don't know if that guy specifically is a bad guy. But let's head up for some air. I feel like I've wandered a lot deeper than I've wanted to. Alright, here we go. So even this is like a little too deep for me. You start running into some really nutty creatures that, oh, but the crystal. Okay, now we have enough for fins, which means we'll be able to swim a lot faster. So I'm gonna head back. If we can grab some food beforehand, that'll be nice. But not my priority at the moment. And I can't. Oh, there we go. There's the beacon. Grabbing fish is like surprisingly hard. Harder than it should be, I think. 'Cause the graphics, although they look good, they're a little choppy. So that's just to compress, you know, take up less space. Then we're gonna make ourselves some fins. There we go. You can see that's equipped, and the tank, I guess, it lives there, and it helps you. So let's go. Eventually, this is our first night. We're gonna need it's very difficult to even align yourself. Catch. Okay, I got one. I guess I can only carry one piece of food at a time? This poor guy, look at him. And eventually when I find salt, I'll be able to cure the fish, and I assume that means I can carry it with me. So, but for now, we're gonna eat you. I'm not sure what that is. I'd like to fix this. Like, I don't know what this is, but I want to fix it. So, let's try. Maybe see if there's a way to repair that. Because this is gonna be our place to hang out. Storage cube. I don't know about that. All right, let's see what we need to make our most basic survival knife. We need titanium, which we have in silicone rubber. So let's go find out, go find some crystals, which is easier at night. They sparkle, so you can see some right over there. I really do not want to get attacked right now. And there's some right there. So we're gonna just like super... Where'd you go? Where'd you go? Well, I was trying to feed myself. But let's just head up topside. So another survival sandbox type game I got into early access is ARK Survival Evolved. And I am not a fan of that, and I'm kind of disappointed that I got in on that. One major complaint is that it runs, the graphics are not optimized. They're just super choppy, even for computers that should. Alright, so that's my quick slot. Quick access slot is assigned to 2 at the moment. The thing with this knife is, let's just grab as much stuff as we can. You know what? Let's just go for it. I haven't seen this guy yet. I'm probably gonna die now. Whoa, I died and lost some stuff. Okay. But I gained water and food, so maybe suicide is the way to go. So this knife is, it's a consumable object. You're gonna need to remake it at some point. But hopefully by then you'll be adept enough at navigating the environment that you'll be able to move on and make better items. But you can see that, I used it once, and so it dropped by 1%, and now I'm right-clicking, and I'm not hitting anything at all, I'm just doing this, and you'll be able to see that it dropped to 91%, so that's basically it. Let's go out there and look for a couple more things. I'd like to find some salt. And we're gonna need to collect some coral. I don't remember why. I just remember. Oh, I think we needed to. Make bleach or something. So we're looking for salt. At this moment, and this is like, okay, so this you can pick up, but if you stab it, you're not going to be very happy. If you use your strafe keys, you'll just kind of tilt back and forth, but you're really just going to be using W and your mouse to look. Oh, salt. Okay.
Insurgency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
And there's a couple more things I just discovered by accident. That's a really nice knife, by the way. Okay. We'll just see what that does. Oh, I think these are bad guys. Why isn't it dying? Well, in any case. So this environment is a lot different from the last one that was generated.
Warning, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
We're good. We'll be good. We're good. We're good. Super, super different. I think, what did we need? We needed it to make bleach, which I think is really funny that has the same icon as fresh water, because you should not drink bleach. But I know that
readings from the aurora suggest erratic fluctuations in the primary dark matter containment field. A breach of the main drive chamber may cause a cascaded quantum flux detonation.
I know that, you know, like in food service and sanitization, just a few parts per million of bleach, will, really help with, oh, see, like, that's deepness I don't necessarily want to go to, but I got what I wanted. Let's get the fuck out of there. Eventually you're gonna, I think, learn how to build your own vehicles by picking up these remnants. But I haven't really come across a need for that yet. Let's go get some air. Just want to get as much stuff as possible. We need some food, I think. We really need some food. But look at all of this. It's a lot more compact. Oh, I don't know what that sound is. Sounds bad. I'm not being very situationally aware right now. I'm not looking. I'm hearing some noises. And not investigating. I'm just after all this resources, after all these resources that were not available to me my first playthrough. Oh, I almost got him. We're gonna need to get some air right now.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen.
We're gonna make it. We're good. All right. I am hungry. It says. So yeah, I get a little bit of this kind of choppiness. From time to time, like little spikes. Now, my main goal now is just to catch a fucking fish. Can stay near the surface because I think these guys, yeah, they're like jumping flying fish. They're also really hard to catch for me, given like my reflexes that I'm always complaining about. I swear to God, they're like impossible to grab. Like this guy, come on. Oh, come on. Are you joking? Oh, thank God. Alright, so where are we at? Might as well pick up some salvage. I think that's about all we need for now. Oh, inventory full. So let's drop one of those. And then let's, oh god. I don't know what I did with the crystal. So that'll free up 4 slots for you. Just cause we can, let's dig in some sand. Oh, did we find salt? For some reason it was like the hardest thing to find the last time I played through. Oh, the fish has succumbed to death. Sometimes digging in the sand can reveal some resources. But right now I think we're good. Let's head home, which is where'd we leave? Am I literally lost? Oh, there we are. Can actually travel above water like this. Maybe we can dig over here. So that kind of doesn't make sense that that's just there. I don't know if that's something that I can. In any case. I don't know if fish go bad, but in this game, I mean, but he's looking kind of. Little peeper. So what can I make out of this? Really? I can eat that? Oh no, that's bad. That has lowered my water and my food's probably not very good for you. So let's fabricate some. We'll make some more bleach. We will make a titanium ingot to preserve some space. And turn all that salvage metal into compressed titanium. So we're gonna work on getting some water now. And I think we can make another one. Let's just drink one for now. It seemed to fill me up a lot, so I feel like it'd be wasteful to get to 100. Like, maybe we wouldn't be using it to its full potential. I don't know what you use copper ore for. I want to fix this guy so bad, and I don't know how. We don't need to be carrying that much titanium. So if you eventually fill up all your storage space, you will start dropping stuff into the ocean, to the bottom of your ship. What was this? I don't know how to use it, so we'll leave it there for a minute. We'll try using this. I think this is in quick slot one. Alright. It seems like the pod is disintegrating. Know why I can't.
Warning, readings from the Aurora exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the dark matter containment field.
Can I really only carry one fish at a time?
Suggest an uncontrolled cascade detonation will occur with a probability of
3.5%. Alright, we're on a hunting spree! Oh, nope, gotta go this way. To Shmoil. I want to just try and get that guy. Come here. Right, we have 3.
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Let's try curing. Oh, we don't have any more salt, huh? Well, in any case. Increases your water as well. So, oops. Let's see what our next step up. Gotta up our game in terms of gear and tools. Radiation suit. The main ship that we crashed from, will begin to, or is emitting, radiation. That's really cool, and we can actually make that right now. Laser cutter cuts things open. So we need to get a bunch of creep vine, which we had. I fucked up by eating it. Don't do that. Isn't this creep vine? Yes. Hold on, I think I need to back up a little. These controls are a little, I don't really know what happened with that. That's really beautiful, the sunset. Graphics are simple, but they're really, they're nice. Let's see if we can make that dive real. Got my knife out just in case. Dang it! I need one more. And some titanium, which I think we put all of it in storage like a big dummy. I'm not great at this yet. So I think that'll be the last thing that we do. Night, but we've survived two nights so far, I think, which is pretty good, but we're gonna need to start I don't know why it's not letting me not allowing me to cut any creep vine. Maybe this one. Okay, there we go. Let's get out of here. Warning. Only 15 seconds of oxygen remaining. We'll see what it does, if it helps us with anything. I haven't even looked. A beacon. Huh! Sounds good. Don't need it right now. I think we need to equip. That's two. Okay, I switched it because I feel like the knife is the most important thing. So let's right click. Oh, that's a bad guy right there. See that thing? It wants me. So what do? I left click. Well, let's go further and then see what happens.
Emergency. Readings from the Aurora show severe instability in the primary drive core. The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state. In T minus. 10. 9,
ah, Jesus.
8. Okay. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
So I think the main ship just exploded. And I actually don't remember what they said about the real. What do I need to do? No, come back here. You're my dinner, come back. Oh my god, this is driving me insane. It's so hard. Ugh. I don't really remember how to use this thing at all.
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
So depending on how much you're into survival games or sandbox games, this can be really fun. For me, it's a little bit exhausting. Let's just make it. Anything? Benzene. I don't know what blood oil is. We need to cook some food. We can make another tank. Alright, just because I'm not too serious right now, let's just make another one and see if we can... Oh yeah, we have so much more air now. Alright, I don't know that that's something that we can even use. I think it might have to go with something else. Save, and let's just take a break there. So I mean, that's basically it. You're just doing that and increasing the complexity of what you're able to build until you get to like a blueprint of entire vehicles, things like that. So, and I don't know if there's like an end game final objective, but I don't know that I'm ever gonna find out. This is not really my favorite kind of game, but it's engaging and a lot more functional during its early access development stage than Ark Survival Evolved, which I'll probably make a video about to see how it's gotten along in the last couple of months, because I just dropped it. I was like, I never want to touch this again. It barely moves, it's so choppy. I'm getting like 5 frames per second on my gaming PC that I bought in 2015. Lot of complaints, also a lot of you know, commendations about how creative it is. For me, it was kind of like the release of Spore back in the day. There was so much hype surrounding how, you know, vastly creative and innovative the game was, and by the time it actually reached its final state, it had been kind of dumbed down to the point of being very unexceptional. And there's also a very high learning curve with Ark. You really need to work to survive, but most of the experiences that I had were like running into either well-established clans or tribes that would just destroy you for no reason, even though I pose no threat, which is fine. I think it's part of the experience. Or I'd run into like other just like naked dudes in loincloths who'd be like, hello, and kind of follow me around, and just a lot of like things with the, I don't know if it's like the AI or whatever, that were just not, shouldn't have been released even in early access. So this is like a much more polished, finished product, and I mean, if you like this kind of game, I would absolutely recommend it. It's, the graphics are good, it's simple and cartoonish in a way, but really rendered beautifully, like the sunset, the crystals, the bioluminescent creatures at night, all of that looks really good. It does jump around a little bit on the highest settings. I haven't even tried it on the lower settings because I want my game to look good, and I want to see how much it can handle, how much my PC can handle. But overall, like, not very many problems, just like, I literally spent an hour not understanding how to open my PDA, so that's probably my fault, but I don't think that I didn't think I could find any of, like, the keybinds or controls. I might be wrong about that, but in any case, just, like, understand the basics of how storage works, how fabrication works, and You'll probably get a lot further than I do, a lot faster than I do, because this is just not my type of thing. But yeah, it looks good. Try it out.